I'm going to show you how to create a mobile UI design project with Canva and all without burning a hole in your wallet. First things first, if you don't have a Canva account, you can sign up for free in the description down below. Click on Create a Design and come to the bottom section and click on Custom Size. For this project, my screen size is going to be 414 by 896 pixels. Once you have your screen size down, just click on Create a Design. Click on your canvas and come to the top toolbar and select background color. You can pick one of these basic default colors or choose a custom color. I'm going to go full custom, so I'll come to the plus icon and add my custom hex code. Now I'll add a trendy image that represents the app. Click and drag into position, then click and drag on any of the four handles to reduce or enlarge the image size. Now let's add a fade to the image so it's not so harsh. Come to your toolbar and select elements. Then come to your search bar and type in gradient fade and click this one. Now we want to rotate it. To do that, come to the little circle icon and click and drag. Lastly, we want to change the color so it blends with the background. Come to your toolbar and click on color and select the color you use for your background. Now let's add in the logo. Then just add it into your canvas and adjust to your liking. Now I'll add in a headline. So come over here and select the text tool. Next, we can browse through all the font combinations and fonts Canva has to offer. But for now, I'll just come here and select add a heading. Now select type and come to your toolbar and select the dropdown to see all the additional fonts you can choose from. I'll choose Archival Black, then I'll just position it here for now. Now I'll add a subhead right underneath the headline by repeating the same process. Now let's add a big old button under the text. Come to your toolbar and select Elements. From there, go to your search bar and type in Modern Geo Round and select that bad boy twice. Move the first rectangle into position and then add in the other to make a long rectangle button. Moving on, I'll add some copy to my button by repeating the same process we just covered. And finally, I'll add a callout under the button for users who already have an account. And your first screen is done. Come over here and click on the plus icon. Now I'll add in the Amazon Music logo by going to upload and locating the file on my device. Then I'll come to the toolbar and click on Elements and search for a user icon. Then I'll add a headline and put it right about here. Now let's add a search function right under the headline. Come to Elements and search Round Square and select this one. Then resize it, put it into place, and then change the color. Now let's add in an icon that will tell the user you can search here. Come to your Elements tab yet again and type in Search Icon, and then pick something that works for you. Then I'll resize and add in some copy like we did before. Next, let's add in a What's New selection to display new releases. First, I'll add in some copy like we've been doing, and then I'll start adding in some album art. So come to your Elements and type in Frame, and then I'll choose this round box. Next, I'll upload the album art and just click and drag it into the frame. Then I'll resize and adjust the position. Lastly, I'll add in some copy to support the album and the artist. Then just copy what we just created by clicking the different elements and holding down Shift. Then you can right click and select copy or hit Command C on your keyboard. Then I'll repeat the same process to fill out the rest of the screen. And then I'll go ahead and add a nice gradient fade near the bottom to let the user know they can scroll. To do that, come to your first screen and copy the gradient we added in before and just paste it into your new screen. Now let's move on to the last screen. Let's duplicate the screen by coming to the plus icon again. Then click and drag on your screen to select everything but the top logo and the user icon. Then hit delete on your keyboard. Now I want to add the album art in the background, but I don't want it to be really visible. To do that, I'll select the album art I want to add into my canvas. Then I'll size the image up and center it. Next, with the image selected, come to your toolbar and select on Edit Image. Then come to Adjustments and select See All. Now come to your blur slider and push that bad boy down to the right, maybe to something around like 20. Now I'll come to the Transparency option and drop that down to around 35%. Then come to your previous screen and copy the gradient again and paste it in so it blends well with the background. Now I'll come back to my uploads and select the album art, adjust the size, and position it. Next, I'll add in some copy letting the user know which album and song is playing. Now I'll create the progress bar by first adding in a simple line. So come to Elements and search for Line. I'll then adjust the size and placement. Then I'll duplicate the same line we just made and shorten it a little bit and change the color to reflect the rest of the design. Now we can add a little circle to tell the user where they are in the song. With the Elements tab still open, search for circle and select the one that works and resize and position. I'll also add some small copy on both sides with a timestamp because I'm extra. Next, we're going to add in the play, fast forward, and reverse feature under the progress bar. So add in a circle like we did previously and change the color to white. Then duplicate that circle again and change the color, size, and position. Now come to Elements and search for play button and pick the one that looks nice and clean. With your Elements tab still open, search for fast forward, and you know the deal by now, I'm going to resize and position near the play button, then copy that and paste it on the other side. The last thing I want to do is add in some additional user icons near the bottom, but unfortunately Canva does not provide any of those icons I was looking for, so I had to use a third-party site. But really, this is all up to you, so play around and see what you can create with Canva.